to forgive you when you go against the grain where I'm from, they just kill you. All these niggas screaming, not familiar, not familiar. How you a killer with some feelings? Catch him on a block, hit a nigga in the ceiling. Niggas rapping, they don't li-
What's the word? It's your boy Matt, aka Jonah Matt.
It's your boy Juice Osama.
And y'all know, man, it's your boy Clutch, man. This is Love and Loyalty, the podcast, man. What it do?
What it do? What's up?
Hey, look, today we're going to start it off a little different. We're going to start off with story time. So it's something different we're trying to try, just, you know, be that we've been having a lot of different conversations amongst each other. So, I want me to do it.
Go ahead.
All right. See, a lot of people be saying, people that know me, they be trying to say that I'm not racist, but what's the other word? See, yeah, they be trying to say I'm prejudiced. Let me explain my reason why I act the way I act. So when I was 9 years old, I ended up moving to Alabama. A lot of people don't know this. I ended up moving to Alabama for some, you know, my people and shit. And I was told you I was bad. I used to do a lot of bullshit. So I legit went down there, little corner store. You know, niggas broke type shit. One of them was throw some little candy and shit. Thing ain't nothing else.
What that candy look?
I think it was a Kit Kat, something like that.
Kit Kat.
Yeah. Man, get this motherfucker. Thinking I'm away with him, thinking I'm good to go. Motherfucker, they called me. I don't think, you know, back here what they do. Man, give me that boy, get out the store, don't come back type shit. Down there is different. They legit grab my little ass up, pause. They tied me to the fucking tree. It's all white people. Tied me to the tree and beat the fuck out of me. Like, beat the shit out of me, bro. Like, it's crazy.
Don't try.
Huh? That's why I am the way I am towards them people now. And I swear, the worst thing ever is I've been seeing my cousin. He was with me, my oldest cousin. This weak ass nigga running down the street. I'm getting my ass beat. They got me tied to a tree, beating my ass.
Say word.
Huh?
How fast
is he running? Nigga, Usain who? Got nothing on that nigga. Out of that. Gone. I'm like, what the fuck? I'm getting my ass beat.
Somebody got
I just
to
look
beat.
Up. I just see this nigga running like a little ass man.
He said somebody
put you on display.
Huh?
They put you on the split.
Well, yeah, that shit was no joke.
They strip you naked?
No, they ain't gonna do all that.
They
beat
you with
your
phone. Yeah. You ain't feel shit,
bitch.
What? It was in the wintertime.
Bro, one thing about it, no.
You ever got a woman?
It was in the summertime. I just see. Hold on. You just see this one thing we just found out this nigga don't listen. So I said this was, I went down there for the summer.
You did.
Yeah, shit was crazy, but yeah, that shit legit fucked me up. But the crazy part is, if that shit was real, like that shit really happened to me, like that would be really fucked up. Like, I ain't gonna lie, I'd probably be killing people right now. But,
I really would like to know how many people really like believe this story. What's funny is, I'm saying how many people believe this story, but we straight got some partners, we was down in Florida. And this nigga straight told this same fucking story. And these niggas was like, and like damn, that's fucked up. That shit really happened to you. Like, he sold this story. Was like, man, y'all niggas be goofy. That's dumb as a motherfucker.
That's not goofy. Let me tell you something, right? Why I found out about myself. I'm a very talented liar.
Everybody got their trait. Everybody good at
something.
Everybody
good at something. So, once again, it's
like find out what it is. Everybody good at something.
For the Harry Potter fans,
I was about you there.
It's like you know, the nigga that would say Harry Potter, he was able to talk to snakes and be a good guy at the same time. Talking to snakes supposed to be like a bad thing type shit. So, I'm just, like I say, it's a fucked up talent. But that's why I say
talent is your talent. Maybe you need to be a
lawyer.
Get that
money.
Shit, fuck that. I play too much.
What's the
I was a motherfucker would be.
Yeah.
Him.
Shit,
that nigga getting people home. I just seen that nigga got a girl home, just killed her.
Hey, that's
boyfriend.
That's Rob.
You know,
he probably sell somebody up the road too. You know how they go. That's Rob's sister.
Somebody
gotta
take a leak. Somebody
gotta
take a leak for that though.
Man, that shit crazy. That was what's name people. That's the one who legit. That's the first person I ever heard him getting off of them for Candace Johnson and shit. Went to Central.
Right.
my boy's getting
goofy
smart.
Ass.
My boy's getting smart. That ain't a problem for him. I was talking the other day with this girl and shit. Just reaching out talking to her, whatever, and I found out something just different. There's three different types of females in St. Louis. Only three. Girls that shop at Walmart, girls that shop at Target, and girls that shop at BOPO. So the girls that shop at Target supposed to be the bougie, you know, upscale ones. They said the Walmart girls are the ratchet ones. And the ones that go to both, they just confused. And the girl, she say, sis, so what type of girl do you like? I say, shit. I like all of them. I don't really got no type. I ain't gonna lie to you. Cause I love a ratchet Walmart store. Going to Walmart, yeah, ratchet.
You
see everything.
You're Walmart type. You definitely Walmart type.
I can't do Target. Target, you walking in that motherfucker, everybody whispering. Like you see the kids just way well behaved. And I'm like, what the fuck going on? I'm on the phone. Hey, look, let me call you back. I'm in Target. I'm like, what the fuck? You can't talk to me because you're in Target?
Kidnapped
is that. Man, I swear to God, Target different. You're like, get out. That's how it is. For real. But nah, a girl just told me that she's three different types of females in St. Louis. Walmart girls, Target girls, and the girls that go to both. They said the girls that go to Target, those are the ones you bring to your mama. And Walmart girls, those are the ones you hit the cop with. Both of them, you might be able to get a couple threesomes out of both. They go to both stores.
You
said
it's going
to
be the cop
with. I ain't like the conversation from here last time. You ain't like the cop shit. What's he in here like? You giving up the guy code. Is it a such thing? Do people really believe in that, like, guy code?
Hell yeah. I don't think people like obey that. I mean, obey that anymore. Like, niggas break a lot of the guy code.
Like what?
Like what one they broke?
Don't fuck no bitches fucking with your dog. That's law.
They checking, we straight shopping, still behind on they bills. Damn, crazy with the stimuli, they stimulated. I up my price and ain't no telling how much they finna pay me. They in they feelings lately, see me pulling up in the latest. And I ain't know you felt like that, I guess you been a hater. Told it for safety, but this bitch don't even come with a safe. Her phone they even asked.
That was
easy.
Huh? That was
easy.
Lying in this pillow talk.
About their partners? About their friends?
You wouldn't believe
it. So is it valid? Is it fucked up if you already get the pussy and you still pillow talk? So if I already got the pussy and I'm just like, so what's up, John Boy, little bit? I'm like, man, nigga, don't say I'm being on shit, lame ass nigga, you know, whatever. Like, if I did, is that still fucked up?
Yeah, that's
what she brought you up. Nah, I ain't gonna lie. This thing so like, look, I ain't gonna lie, long for real. You already know me. If a girl, I don't care who it is, like legit. When we say check the Carfax, we can check. And this with both of y'all. If a girl will just say some shit like, yeah, what's up with your people? I'm like, man, shit, that's my dog. Like, shit, my brother, look, I let a nigga real ass nigga. I said about all my partners. I ain't gonna lie. Even if I know y'all some fucking sleaze balls back in the day type shit, I'm always gonna. I just told, just throw the conversation off with. I'm a great liar. So I always lie to the girls, like, yeah, them niggas are some stand-up guys, they doing their thing. I'm like, yeah, you would, like, no, go fuck with
that's
it.
That's because to the outside world, man.
That's how y'all got your relationship right now.
And to the outside world, man, I mean, everybody supposed to be a boss, but in the outside world, you want everybody to think that everybody a boss in your circle.
So you saying you a puzzle. Basically, if we go out tonight, a motherfucker do not supposed to look at us and be able to tell which one got the money.
Facts.
Right.
Y'all supposed to be on the same level. That's how it should be. No, that's a boss code. Because if I got it, if I got it, if I'm the nigga with the money, and y'all coming out with me, and I'm fresh, y'all, no, that's not, no, that's, I'm gonna hold this money, I'm gonna pinch y'all off to keep y'all around, no. If I got this money, I'm gonna put y'all on, y'all gonna get this money too. So if I fall off, I know y'all got my back. Yeah, even if you ain't got the money, when we go out right now, see, you shouldn't look like you ain't got the money, even if you ain't got the money, so we all blend in together.
So let's be honest right now. So when you come out to our circle, not just us three, but everybody that, you know, everybody else might not know what we're talking about, but all the people that we know. That's how it go?
I mean, no. I ain't gonna say no, it don't, but like when the bucks was up, it was.
See, the bucks was up, that was different. Like, I'm talking about niggas in the home and drink, nigga. I popped up. What's that, bucks, pink slip?
Bucks, yeah.
Here go here. Here go Patron by the mother. Mother took his, that wasn't even out yet. Mother took a sip of Patron.
Say, nigga, see this for what?
Swear to God, take a sip and let your boo.
They can see the owl. Billy, have a Billy. Stop
that. Fucked it up, man. But nah, like I said, with that type of shit, like you said, I don't think, but our circle alone, like, if I'm being honest now, we don't get it like that. We got some guys where most of us, if it's 10 of us, I'm going to say, shit, 9 of us like that. If one of them might, okay, let me change it. For me, all 10 of us are like that. For me, But for other people in the group, everybody's not treating everybody like they treated me.
They all got different relationships.
But it shouldn't be like that. If we all friends, consider ourselves family, friends, whatever, it shouldn't be like that. I mean, like I said, they go back, like I said, we're going to cause some gap code. We're going to treat all my dogs the same. And no picking and choosing on where I like this friend more than I like this friend. Like, nah, everybody beneficial. Like, shit, I know when we come after me, like, you know.
You just got to know who for what. Like, you know what I'm saying? You don't call everybody for everything. You know
what I'm saying? If I'm about to go, if I'm about to go,
I love everybody the same, but I don't call you for this. Football play, I'm not going to call you to go hoop. You know what I'm saying? Like, you just got to know your personality for what's going on.
If we going to the club to get on some females, I know which one of my homeboys I'm taking with me. Like, flat out. I know which one I'm taking with me. The one they gonna give me the most attention. The one they like, okay, I gotta choose between these niggas right here. I'm gonna take this nigga. So if that man chose, who y'all think I'm taking? What niggas let me play?
You want me to answer
that? Yeah, fuck, who can answer, nigga? Motherfucker, you think you my son for real? I went out last night with my nigga Angelo. Motherfucker like, damn. You Bill Daddy? I'm like, I'm who daddy? Like, nah, everybody
say the same
shit.
Where
your daddy
at, man?
Where your
pop?
I'm like, man, look.
Hey, look. Fuck all that fantasy shit you talking about.
Sure.
Check out, though. Hey, look. So, look. If you can go back, let's say, to middle school, right? Mm-hmm. Erase all the mistakes. You know what I'm saying? All the mistakes you did back then. But you start over from then, you don't remember none of that shit. You go back in time and start back from middle school.
I don't know what mistakes are. See, it's different. Yeah, middle school, because middle school for us was different from middle school for them.
Wait.
Normally middle school, I swear to God.
I'm saying middle school up to now. Like any mistake you feel like you made.
Like you said, start at middle school. Middle school, I ain't going to lie. You didn't even know if you made, if there was mistakes. Because nigga, you can legit probably have 5 fights. Get suspended, all types of shit. He's just gonna graduate from summer school. Bro, I swear to God, I got kicked out like the last month of school type shit. Went to summer school and said you just graduated by doing it. Like, you can legit get kicked out the second day of school, go to summer school and make it. Normally middle school, like, I ain't gonna lie. Bro, what you talking about? Lean on me, bro. Niggas talking about the high school.
Oh my God.
You can make it to the middle school, you making it anywhere. All, bro, it was nothing but fights, lockdowns. Like, fights, bro, it was so fun. Like, hella fun. Like, nigga, you talking about lockdown, they searching lockers, all this goofy ass shit.
That big ass fight at the Metro Link?
Oh, that was us. We wasn't in middle school, though, man. We was in high school. How you gonna tell me, nigga? It was started because of me.
Yeah, we walked down. Yeah, how you gonna tell me?
It started because of me, shit. Me. Niggas tried to jump me, you know, nigga, they don't know, nigga. What's wrong with me? Motherfucker, you know the fuck. They messing with the boss, man. What the fuck wrong with you niggas, man? We're gonna pull up. We're gonna pop out. What's wrong? Shit. Check the car fact. Started a whole beef band and shit. Everything did and everything cool. Motherfucking matured and grew up and shit, but it was the past. Like I say, check the car fact. People know this shit is real. That's what I'm saying, too. But no, if I could.
I'm curious how y'all think my middle school went, though.
What middle school you went to Hazelwood? What was it? Kirby?
I was cool.
Y'all had the peanut butter and jelly sandwich with no crust.
Uncrusted.
They gave us sandwiches with just the crust. Like, nigga, it was different. Y'all had the best thing we had at Normandy Middle School was the super donut things.
Yeah, that and was, the fancy machine. Oh, yeah. That shit was good.
My nigga Fredo, Big Fredo on the ground every day grabbing sodas off the people. You want this flavor? I'm talking the whole cafeteria.
Fancy, cool. They stayed with that.
No, but I just feel like Kirby was a little peonish.
Black mob and all that shit came from.
I'm even starting that bullshit.
Yeah, I bet you came right after. And we was out banging. Hood, we was out banging.
Clicks.
That was clicks.
It was clicks.
And they had like the Cowboy Boys and some shit.
That was Jarvis.
Oh yeah, that's coming from y'all. You talking
Jarvis and Normandy.
Oh no, Jarvis from Normandy. Yeah. Nothing
on them. Looking into it, them niggas went to Normandy claiming their shit, but them niggas wasn't from a hood. If you go to this motherfucking, there's 20 hoods in this motherfucking. And you just, I don't know why they did it. Like, it ain't like they had fights with Normandy niggas. they went and they tried to fight against Hazelwood niggas. I don't know, but.
Yeah, you think it was a difference from
normie
niggas and like
Hazelwood niggas? I'm not saying, so me back in the day, I did. I ain't gonna lie, back, just like most people in the city would say, city niggas, county niggas, all this type of shit. Back in the day, I most definitely did think it was a big difference until, like I say, me getting older and legit bumping into shit, like I say, my long lost son, and just realized, like, man, you niggas, I ain't gonna say far from the same tree as me, because I'm not even about to lie to y'all and say that, but niggas is some close seconds, like.
This nigga live like a world.
Check the car facts. The guys that know us, yeah, I know what I'm talking. I'm not lying. I told her that's a talent of mine, but right now I'm not lying. Motherfucking dog. Yeah, hey, tell her it was two different playing fields when it comes to this.
Y'all ball at your own race. At your own pace.
Hmm?
You said it. Y'all ball at your own pace. Y'all ball at your own pace.
My boy, I ain't gonna lie. Hey. Life on the line.
Y'all ball at your own pace.
Hey, man, life on the line. Listen. We gotta get away.
Hey, listen. What? Yeah. Let me tell you, you take the court face. I got court face. That you just. Man, y'all ball at your own pace. I'm get away from the police. Hey, listen.
Who you calling?
High speed Bill, where you at? Real
man.
Listen.
You say, nigga, the house surrounded. These niggas trying to get me.
Who's that movie? Who's that movie? Baby Driver? That nigga's getting out of there.
Say, just jump the back.
I'm gonna say, Joe, lay down, bro. I'm about to pull up. Just pull up. This is back in the day, though. I for real, on some real shit, like, bro, no bullshit, like, and it's so crazy. Bro, I just had to talk with Lil Durk and Drayden, like, last week, and it's straight crazy. Me and Los went out last night. Me and Los, just us. Ambassador, hella people, Jay Morley, birthday party, shout out my nigga Jay Morley.
Yeah, shout out my nigga Jay Morley, man. He most definitely, we got something coming up with Jay Morley, too, man. Y'all stay tuned to that, too.
Left third. You know, anybody know me, know I don't fuck with clubs at all. We leaving low, like, shit, we trying to do. I'm like, what you mean? Like, you want to cross over? I'm like, man, you driving, whatever. Well, I was like, you got your gun? I'm like, you know I got my thumb. Lying like a motherfucker. Nigga made it all the way over that motherfucker. I'm talking about turned up, thugging, whatever.
Yeah, I was cool. Y'all had like a little G2.
Huh? We ain't had shit.
Shit, they was naked.
Nope, I swear to God, we was straight naked. But this is the thing, I ain't gonna lie. And I don't know if it's just like motherfucking energy, like I say, back in the day, I swear, it was like, and I know it still can happen like that now, you still get into it that fast, but now we went in this motherfucker, I'm like, people I don't even know, or people I haven't seen, me and Lowe's haven't seen, the hell of first number all of. No yeah, bullshit, to the point.
It's like people, you don't walk around now? with that, like that energy, so a motherfucker ain't giving it out, you know
still
what
got
I mean?
The
like,
energy word, like, but motherfucker,
yeah, like, I'm still me at the end of the day, you know what I'm saying?
Even, what's his name? What's your boy's name? T. Morley. Even like I'm talking about, hey, come on, let me brother. Like, yeah, I like the podcast. Boo boo. Y'all had Reggie on the show. Boo boo. Yeah, fuck with me. Like, I swear to God, just off of like, I never met the man, but just on some shit like that, on some straight just, like I said, the energy was straight. I don't know what it was last night. It ain't to the point where it's about to have me clubbing, cause that's not the case. But like I said, it's just shit to the point. People that know me, man, for me to be outside, I swear to God, I don't think I came in the last time. But once again, let me make sure I say this too while I'm saying this. I probably ain't rolled around with a gun or nothing on me in probably, I don't know, 6 months. But don't fucking play with me. You gonna say that. If you're dumb enough, hey, I'll snap your fucking neck.
You don't want no problem.
Well, nah, I swear to God, yesterday straight was different though, like for like just, and like I say, anybody that know me know like that shit ain't like you said, nigga, that ain't normal. To the point we are outside like this anywhere for real, even going down the street, you're gonna use a guy thumper. Uh-huh. Going on the east side, around 1,000 motherfuckers, straight nothing.
Yeah,
I ain't like, feel no way, it wasn't on no straight like
you ain't giving that type of energy off. Like when we was young and shit like that, it just was, we always felt like something was gonna happen. Like, we always just felt like, you know what I'm saying, something was gonna happen. So you all 10 and you looking for it, you know what I'm saying. Now you going or whatever you're going into, you know what I'm saying, with just a clear mind, not looking for no bullshit, just to enjoy the time and see. That's what energy bring off, and that's what other people's energy gonna feed off you.
You still, you feel that way now?
Yeah.
So you telling me you legit moving around with no thumb?
I'm not.
With this last, the last 2 days, I done had it, the last bedroom. Before that, I ain't had the one for like 2 months. Like a month, I'm gonna say like a month.
I was sure about saying, nigga, you fucking lying.
I'm gonna say like a month.
But that's why I don't be rolling around guns on, because if anything ever happened, like I said, you supposed to know your personnel. My dogs right here, I know for a fact. They're like, here, Juice, take the gun. And I'm gonna have to do my thing and save our lives. Like, I know this already.
Right.
Let me stop.
Somebody
gotta
take the case. Somebody gotta take the case. Here, Juice, take the gun. Somebody gotta take the case.
Look, we gotta stop talking about these cases.
Somebody gotta take the case.
We all know.
Still trying to take that case, boy. That's what we gonna give you the motherfuckers for. That's what it's over with. Right over with.
It's different. Let me tell you like this. Once again,
wait.
Joe, look, let me tell them right this. Real shit. Check the Carfax. The real ones don't never get caught. But, you gonna thug it like that. Nah, but on some other shit, like, we had one of the DM questions too. Let me sit down and look at you. Somebody wrote in the DM and said, who comes first in a relationship between your wife, your girlfriend, or your kids? That's easy for me. My kids come before everybody. My kids, I'm not gonna say why.
So what would you feel? Okay, if we, if I'm married, okay, like if it's a burning, if I gotta get the ass out of a burning house.
No, right. So if
who I'm saving?
No.
Or just like who?
So if your kid and your mom get to argument, who you choose?
Well, I'm
shooting. Basically, in a situation like that, who gonna come first in your life? Is it gonna be your brother?
So basically right. if your mama and your kid and they legit about to fight, and one of them taking the ass from them, but you gotta jump in and save the one taking the ass. Who you helping? I got a girlfriend. I'm knocking you the fuck out. I ain't gonna lie. I'm the dog shit out of you for my mama.
Yeah, I guess it's something like that.
I don't give a fuck. I mean, if you my wife, look.
Nah, with something like that, like a fight or some shit like that. With something like that, a fight, something like that, you know your mom always come first. I think your mom probably the first person, the most important person.
Let me ask you a question, hold up. So in your relationship right now, with that question, who do you think come first in, or just put in order in your situation, but just try to think for your partner. So you know what I'm saying? So try to answer for her.
I can't.
Why not? I could. For my ex, that's easy. I can answer right now. Her mama, her siblings, her friends, then me. I can answer. I'm going to keep it 100. I can answer.
Her mama, like, you mean like her mama?
I went dead.
So I went, you went, girl. So I went like.
Nah, I'm talking about her mama.
So what would she rank you?
Like, what is the pecking order?
That's why I said it.
I'm not talking about her. We're talking about the mom.
Okay, now her mama.
I know the answer.
I know I better come first.
Nah, it ain't about what you better do.
Be honest, kids probably come first.
Kids supposed to.
Kids gonna come first. I think I come second. See,
I think in your situation, it's the kids. I think it's the mom.
Oh my God.
I think you're on the level of the siblings or something. Like the brothers.
Damn.
And them is legit. Like you neck and neck with them.
That's most definitely dead. That's great. What about
an artist? Yeah. Are you good at it?
Yeah. Bitch, I'm in my bag. Yeah.
It's gonna be the baby. Me.
Only the baby? What? You got other kids, nigga?
In her situation, not me, nigga.
Oh.
Oh, okay. I don't have kids. What you talking about? You get ass him in her situation. Even in her situation, your kids, her kids, y'all married now. That's where I think I go. Let me just shut up.
That's right. You're right about that. But it's still going to be some type of difference between having your own kid and your stepkid. It shouldn't be one, but the bond's going to be different. The bond is going to be different.
I think that depends on the parent, if it's my stepson, I treat him just like he my blood, bro, what's gonna be the difference?
It's crazy
because the baby came out of her. These are her stepkids. We can go our separate ways. She's still gonna have this baby, so the bond is gonna be different.
I mean, I don't know. I ain't in a position. I don't know. I'm just saying what I would think. What you say though?
In that type of situation, it's a little bit, that's different. Like you say, it's about the parent, the parents, about the individuals, all types of shit. Like, you are, everybody always said back in the day, female, like, I can't date no nigga with kids. Mm-hmm. Being in St. Louis, I ain't gonna lie, low-key impossible. Like,
either which way.
Yeah, easy, for real. To me, either which way. I used to always say, if you a good-looking girl, like, I'm talking about, you legit look hella good, whatever, and you're 26 and up, you don't have no kids, either crazy or something, like, something wrong with you. Cause once again, we seen a bunch of baboons getting knocked up. And once again, like, yeah, come on, you telling me what?
Let me see, 30. I can't even probably, that's like, at the top of my head, think of probably five.
The only,
females not pregnant, like 30. Like 30.
I know some lame, like, well, I don't want to say that. I know some partners, they don't got no kids. But when I think about it, why they don't have kids, them niggas are real life losers. My nigga turns P hard in the bridge.
I knew he was gonna say this dude.
31 years old.
I knew he was gonna say this dude.
This nigga can't pay his way into no pussy. God damn, that's my dog. Damn,
boy, I'm like, man. Nigga,
that nigga, I tell him all the time, he can legit see the girl talking. Like, yeah, get her right there at that point and don't close. I'm like, you know what? You crack, you like, nah, man. I was about to, but.
I had a partner like that when we was young.
What movie is that? What movie is that? Horrible. I was about to, but it wasn't the right rhythm. That nigga DJ couldn't crack. My nigga's a non-closer on a basketball court. I'm keeping it 100. He's a non-closer then. He just came down, showed his little highlights of three little jumpers from 40 feet, whatever. 30. We wasn't there to see this shit.
From 30.
But like I said, that type of thing, hey. Hey, look, think about that, because I remember I had this conversation with TJ, and this is the reason he didn't crack one girl. And just keep it 100. In y'all past, keep it 100. Please keep it 100. Have y'all ever fucked a girl raw when you had a condom in your pocket?
Yeah.
Okay, I thought y'all was going to laugh. But man, no, fuck no. I'm going to stop her right there. I'm going to put that. I think every nigga fucked. Well, I don't want to say fucked up and made the mistake, but. A lot of girls gonna look back at this thing, they like, hey, you niggas is nasty. What the fuck? My nigga would never, your nigga would never tell you. But once again, some of y'all are them girls to the point where you about to fuck a nigga, like, legit. I swear to God.
That's probably how y'all first start fucking raw. Like in actuality, them be like, hey,
Have they ever happened like the first time you about to fuck a girl? You got a whole condom in your pocket. You hit raw?
I ain't gonna lie, I'm gonna keep it a fuck. I used to be big on kind of
sushi. Oh,
I know. I want sushi.
Free my nigga BC, man.
Free my nigga BC. BC, real deal sushi.
We know a lot of niggas. Like, this is the thing, even like I say, when people go back and watch this. I guarantee, like, I swear to God, I wish we can drop it where they can do some type of voting thing, because I guarantee if niggas keep it 100, man, hell, niggas didn't did that. I did it before.
We can. We can do a poll on, what's it called?
You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah. We'll do a poll on Facebook. Or is it Instagram
that
got the poll?
That's crazy. Look, this is the thing. So then, that's a bad way to look at shit. Cause I looked at it, I'm like, damn, this girl, she nice, da da da, and she carried herself like she a Chesterfield type of girl. She ain't no nigga until I found her Instagram, and her name was Badass. I'm like, oh, hold up, this is a nigga girl. Like, hold up, had to run, like, check the Carfax on her. Like, she ain't no fucked up female. Like, no, she most definitely.
Say, she a whole different individual. I'm a whole gangsta outside of work.
She's a good person. But no, that happened to me before. I swear to God, I should have got the condom right in my pocket. Like, ooh, I'm gonna slide this motherfucker on. The motherfucker jump on top of that motherfucker. Like, okay, get out of here. What the fuck are you doing?
I think
speed option left. Get that motherfucker out of there. Fuck this.
Hey, everything. What the fuck? It was a what in the what? I'm saying it was a what in the what? She knew too, though. Like, she knew. Like, motherfucker like this, you have, like, she know.
Yeah, but you gotta understand the difference. I keep trying to tell y'all that y'all, I don't think y'all understand it.
This dude is straight fucking loony.
Nah, that's for real.
Hey, yo, so.
So, even with, like I say, my bad. When we talking about the whole GATCO thing. So, this is some real shit. Y'all don't know. Y'all in relationships or y'all been in a relationship. So, I don't really even know if y'all really can answer. But when y'all was single, was it like a list of girls that you don't have, you didn't have to explain to your niggas that's off limit?
Yeah.
So, you know, you my
that's
dog.
Like,
I've been knowing you for
that's
forever.
Yeah, that's like an unreal.
How many girls do you think that was on my list that you just know flat out off limits? Well, you know me. I know it's more than three. I got two baby mamas, so I know it's more than three.
You said before.
I'm talking about now, oh, like in general that you know. Because this is the OG. This shit thrash.
I say seven.
I got seven girls I wouldn't
want to
run into. What about you? What do you think about? What do you think? How many girls did you know that I was messing with that just was off limits to me? Which my partner?
I'm gonna say like four or five.
Give me an initial. I'm gonna pour two down from being who?
Yeah.
I said, you gotta watch. <I'm different. laughs> what about you? What's your name? What
is T.
Yeah, that's my dog.
That's
my dog.
I was
in T. That's my dog.
T. I was in T. J.
That was the last one.
Yeah.
That was the last one.
Y'all might be watching shit. What the fuck is these niggas talking about? We just talking about the little list, like I said, this a bro code thing. Like I said, this is a list where the girls is off limit type shit. Like a lot of people don't, you know, as friends, you don't have to. I never have to tell these guys, like, man, these girls are hurt. Y'all don't touch, don't do nothing with. They can just tell off of the way a nigga move, how a rock and move, like shit. Like I said, it's the same way for all they hoes they got right now type shit. Let me stop playing. These niggas don't like shit like fucking around. I'm just joking, please. They
do hella. Let me ask you this. So is it a timeline on that list?
No.
Nope.
No.
Okay, so is it?
Not for my partners, no.
What extension of partners, though?
My dogs, my partners, the people. Come on, like I said, my friends.
I'm saying like
the circle.
Yeah, the circle.
Instead of media.
The circle, not niggas that use niggas. We hang out with people for certain reasons. Like, no, that's not no real nigga shit. If I don't talk to you, the only time you call me is when you need me for something, if you need my help, if you want this from me, I'm not considering you a friend. You cool. But I'm going to keep it 100.
If he cracked, then he just cracking.
Yep. But I ain't going to laugh. So with that situation, well, you know what I'm saying.
I get what you're saying.
If that person do that, I'm burying that person.
I know what's going on.
But I'm going to bury him. It depends on two of them. Yeah, but two of them. But that's just that, though. Anything else is like, hey, if it's the other way around now, hey,
Boy.
Motherfucker been blocking my blessing. That's how I look at it.
I'm high.
They do crazy motherfuckers. But like I said, in that type of situation, who's wrong? The nigga?
Or the bitch?
Or the bitch? Or the female? Who's wrong? So I see a single girl the other day say, man, I picked the wrong spin. She said, I picked the wrong friend. I got to spin the block and get another one. I just seen that somebody said that shit the other day.
Wait, so we talking about just like the list of females or the babe mama?
The list of females.
I mean, if your babe mama on your list, your babe mama on your list. Now, some people like, some lie, people don't give a fuck about their babe mama.
I got one that's on the list. The other one I really don't.
Yeah, some people, I was just finna say shit, some people don't give a fuck about their babe mama, so shit, their babe mama don't get the list. But then, you know.
Who's you blame if they were to happen?
So if it's a friend,
yeah.
If you my partner and you do that, I already, y'all know how I feel. If you my partner and you do that, I'm gonna beat the shit out of you. Like, we gonna fight. I ain't gonna lie, but that, like, she's gone though. Like, she gotta go. But I will, like, me and my partner, we gonna fight. That's the only way you can handle that.
Yeah,
other than that, just stop talking to a person and just maneuvering away from a person that you've been around your whole life. Yo, like, legit, like I say, even wrong, like, I ain't gonna lie.
Yeah, because I feel like brothers gonna fight.
Don't do shit.
What's crazy is, man, this dude told me this shit when I was younger, bro. This shit stuck with me. Dude say, man, if your bitch try to fuck me, bro, I'm gonna fuck her. And it's like, at the time, you know what I'm saying? We fighting. If bitch try to fuck me, bro, I'm gonna fuck her.
So would you?
Because I said, damn, boy, you scandalous as a motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? You know, tell for my bitch sake, because when you get done, when I tell you,
that she tried,
you're gonna let her go anyway. You know what I'm saying? You either gonna believe me. If you believe, you're gonna let her go anyway. You know what I'm saying? So why not fuck the bitch? You know what I'm saying? You don't give a fuck about her no more. Like, damn, that's crazy, motherfucker, but it kind of made sense.
That's crazy.
So it sounds scandalous, though.
Before you even crack it, would you let that nigga know?
Before
you even crack his bitch or his BM, would you let
that
nigga know?
I know, violation. If this is my brothers, you know what I'm saying? Your bitch try to come fuck me or whatever, you know what I'm saying? Ah, this is a violation. Let them know.
See, the thing about that, I'm not
trying to fuck her, you know what I'm saying? Like,
but that's the thing.
I'm not trying to fuck her.
That go back to knowing your personnel, too, because I ain't gonna lie. A situation like that, let's say, if I come tell you that your bitch trying to fuck, da da da, you be like, damn, all right, go right on. You can legit go in that motherfucker, talk to her, she can legit deny every fucking thing. Legit deny everything. Everything. Like, man, that's a lie. That nigga lying. That nigga been trying to do all this shit with me forever. You need to stop fucking with that nigga.
I'm gonna keep it
right.
And this
the thing, it's a lot of niggas that will be like, all right, babe, you right. And legit cut the partner out and listen to that bitch. And
but
she's wrong.
In reality, for real, he don't believe her.
So my he don't
believe her, but he just scared to leave her.
They go back to knowing your fucking work.
It's a difference, bro. If you've been around, bro, I know when you niggas, like, I can't necessarily just know when y'all lying, but you know, you've been around a motherfucker, you know when a motherfucker lying. You know, you've been around long enough, you can tell when she lying, you know what I'm saying? You know when she lying, when she not, when she too aggressive, when she too faded back on the situation, you know what I'm saying? You can read a motherfucker, so you really know. You know already, you just choosing to ignore the fact. You know what I'm saying? Just choosing to ignore the fact.
Like I say, we need feedback, we want feedback. Help us out with this type of shit. Cause like I said, a lot of people ain't thinking like me, but y'all more thinking
yeah,
like
yeah, y'all wanna be like cornball ass niggas.
Hey, watch your mouth, I'm your father.
Cornball ass niggas.
But nah, for real, we do need the feedback. We need all that shit. We just, like I say, look out, leave comments, help us out.
Hey, man, we ain't just podcasting either, man. Come check us out Sunday, man, up at the field. Ladu, man, kick ass in the
just drop on Sunday.
We drop Sundays too, man. We get outside, we kick it too, though, man.
Yeah, like I said, we got some big interviews coming up. Shit, we got two of them coming up next week. For real. Like I said, man, fuck with us, man. Love and loyalty to the podcast, man. Subscribe. Fuck with us. Y'all know what it is.
On bitch, super thick. My little groupie bitch. Dark skin bitch. Dreads whip designer. Head fit. College bitch. Fuck her with a friend. One Dominican. Trap bitch.